Absolutely.
I'm not sure yet. We're not.
Teachers
not
amazing.
Sure exactly what's going to happen. But I will miss him. And I might.
There you go. Now, would you recommend other children to come to this school?
Yes. All the children to come to this school. It's amazing.
Yeah, that's right.
I am with Gio and his dad. Yes, Gio and his dad. Now, Gio, can I ask you, what grade are you in?
Third grade.
Third grade. And who is your classroom teacher?
Mr. Vito.
Wow. And how many years have you been at Merrick Academy? A year. And how have you enjoyed it so far? Really? Now, on a scale from 1 to 10, Gio, where 10 is the best score, but 1 is the worst score, what score would you give Merrick Academy?
10.
A 10? So, I am here with Maya and her very, very proud mother. Now, would you recommend other children to come to the school? Okay, now what's one fun activity you remember doing while you've been here? You like the art? Okay.
Did you like Chess with Mr. Mia?
Oh, checks in the mail, Maya. Now, I'm in front of two proud Merrick alumni.
Very good school. The basketball and soccer teams are really good. The teachers are very supportive. Whenever you need help, they will come to help you. The senior trip is actually very good. Sometimes we go to the library, the museum. We also go to the pool sometimes in the Sussex Armory.
Excellent, excellent.
Hi, my name is Jemai Brathwaite. I used to go to Merrick Academy, but I am graduating this year and I'm going to 6th grade. I like Merrick Academy because the teachers are really nice and we make a lot of friends. And I like the teams, the sports teams. And I like when we go on field trips because we go to the library, museums, and etc.
Well said.
I like this school because when you need help, the teachers will help you. And when you need help, your friends will also help you.
I like the sound of that. Now, would you recommend the school to other scholars?
Yes.
Now, if you had to rate Merrick, 1 to 10, 1 being the worst, 10's the best score, what score would you give Merrick Academy?
10. All right, go on there. Oh, her dramatic walk to the microphone.
Hey, Black Child by County Color. Hey, Black Child. Do you know who you are? Who you really are? Do you know you can be what you want to be? If you try to be what you can be? Hey, Black Child. Do you know where you're going? Where you're really going? Do you know you can learn what you want to learn? If you try to learn what you can learn? Hey, Black Child, do you know you are strong? I mean really strong. Do you know you can do what you want to do if you try to do what you can do? Hey, Black Child, be what you can be. Learn what you must learn. Do what you can do. And tomorrow, your nation will be what you want it to be.
So here, I'm with a proud parent. This is Megan's mom. And what grade is your daughter in?
Third grade.
Third grade. Let me guess. And her teacher is?
Mr. Vito.
Mr. Vito. Now, how long have you been coming to Merrick Academy?
It's her first year.
First year.
It's her first year.
Excellent. What other school did you come from?
PS
181. Now, if you had to rank Merrick, 1 to 10, 10 being the best, 1's the worst. What number score would you give Merrick Academy?
10.
A 10. Praise God. Okay. 10. Now, can you speak on some of the activities that Megan has participated in this year? What were some of those activities that you really enjoyed for your daughter?
The Wellness Wednesday.
Wellness Wednesday.
The Minion Friday.
Yes.
I'm here. And any activity that I'm home, I participate in first.
Excellent. Now, would you recommend another child coming to Merrick Academy?
Absolutely.
My son is doing well. He came here from kindergarten. He was doing kindergarten. They did a test with him. He passed it, and then he went on now to first grade. He's now an A student. Excellent. I would recommend it to any parents. And he's also a fan of Mr. Mayor. We had to buy him a chess set.
Okay.
Because he's so obsessed with chess.
Oh, I love it.
We would also like to know, me personally as a parent, if you teach music here. Because he's going to music school at Job, but we would like that in the school as well, if it's possible. Because he's learning piano at home and guitar. So if you have that, or if you don't have that, for me, it would be something nice. Because it works a lot with kids' memory. It says a lot to remember all of those keys. So also other parents who haven't done music, it's something nice to have your child done.
So Dad, I know you've been with Gio for a while here at the school. What are some of the programs that you really enjoyed Gio participating in?
His mother calling me now. Well, I like the chess with you, you know, so you could learn other things, think outside the box, how to strategize. Because, you know, life is about, you know, obstacles that we face every day. So that's a good thing. Jim, his teacher's very hands-on. She's great. She's wonderful. Very honest. You know, so Merrick Academy is a great school.
Amen. Now, Mom, I know you've been here for a while. Very expressive about all the wonderful things that Merrick has done in the community and for your child. Could you speak on some of the initiatives that you witnessed here while you've been at Merrick?
Okay, so one of the initiatives is right behind us, so we can see the garden where the children get to plant, right? Learn about nature. Another thing was the playground. That was definitely improved since we've been here, so now they've definitely been able to go outside and play with each other the way we want them to get outside, right? And I'm excited about the language that's coming.
Yes.
So hopefully we can do some Mandarin, something out of the box. And I'm excited to see what's going to come for next year.
All right, so now I'm with another proud parent. She had a son who graduated. She's about to have another child come here in September.
Yes.
Speak on it, please, Mom.
So, my name is Sahai Dixon. I have my son that graduated here. My little one is starting here on July 6th. My nephew is graduating this year. I have a niece that goes here, so I recommend Merrick Academy. It's very well tight-knit. The teachers really put their best foot forward, and it's really like a community. Everyone tries to help everyone.
That's what's up. So you would certainly recommend other children to come here.
I would definitely recommend others.
Can you speak on any of the initiatives that Sasuke might have enjoyed while he was here?
The field trips, the extracurricular activities. He just spoke with Mr. Condison. They want to go back into the soccer.
Oh, excellent.
Now I got to sign them back up for soccer because they want to do the soccer.
Excellent.
So, yeah. They enjoyed the little field days, pajama day. They had movies.
Yes.
So I think 1 year, Sasuke was his last year. They had like a family barbecue. So they enjoyed that. Everyone cooked and brought something. So
that's
that was
up.
Good.
Excellent. Excellent. Yes. Thank you so much for sharing.
No problem.
So right now, believe it or not, ladies and gentlemen, I am with the founder. That's right. Of Merrick Academy, Mr. Malcolm Smith. Mr. Smith, thank you so much for having us out today.
Thank you. Like you said, it was divine providence
that
got us together today.
Absolutely. So can you just tell us a little bit about what your history and your knowledge is of Merrick Academy?
Sure. Well, during the time when I was serving in public office, one of the challenges that I saw was a lot of our young people who lived on the other side of Hillside Avenue had a lot of resources and teachers that were very committed to their programming. Came on this side of town, it was almost like coming to the, you know, across the Mason-Dixon line.
Right.
And while there were some people who had their issues with charter schools, it was clear to me that we needed some type of institutions that was devoted to making sure that our young people became the best that they could be. And that's what got me into the whole route of trying to get together with these charter schools.
So, What has been your experience working with Merrick Academy?
Oh, it's a great school. The teachers are great. The staff is great. I've been with them for going on maybe 3 years back. I've been serving them. They are very, I like the whole, all of them, the whole staff.
And the kids.
And the kids.
The kids are great too. They're very, very respectable.
Yes.
Would you recommend someone else sending their child to Merrick?
Most yes. Definitely. I did already. I got two kids enrolled in their school.
Compare us to those other cookie cutter charter schools in Queens.
Not at all.
I don't want to call names of schools, but one particular one my kids went to when they were younger, it has changed so drastically. It's not the same. They're not so into the kids. They're more doing it like a job.
Right.
This school,
they're into the kids. It's like every one of them is an individual as it should be.
They can't see us in the daytime with the flashlight.
Right. You got that right.
Mr. DeVito is the best. I have to get that on camera.
Thank you.
Mr. DeVito is the best. Merrick Academy is the best.
It's officially recorded.
If you're looking for a place, this is it.
You are the best.
Thank you so much.
And here we have Mr. Connison holding it down as always. Mr. Yes. Connison, can I ask you a couple questions?
Yes, sir.
How long have you been here at Merrick Academy?
I've been here 6 years now.
6 years?
Yes.
Okay, now I'm sure. Would you recommend other children to come to this school?
Certainly.
Certainly, certainly.
Yes.
What's one big takeaway experience that you could take from this school? What's one big thing that you remember?
The family atmosphere, and they really do have an active interest in the children's well-being.
That. My Abby is experience,
not my age. And it was me, you, Daddy. Wake up, everybody. No more sleeping in bed. No more apathetic thinking ahead. The world has changed so very much.
I know, right? With a big ear, sir? Yes, Mr. Sir, so if I could pick you up tall, sir, I would.
War and poverty.
Oh, to your life. Oh, my God, you're so cool.
There is the illustrious Miss Stapleton. How are you, Miss Stapleton?
All the teachers.
It's so great seeing you as well.
They're the ones who come in up what you have to say. They're the ones who's coming up, and the world is in their hands. When you teach the children, teach them the very best you can.
You didn't see me, I gotta roll up on her. She runs the discussions.
She's just you and me.
On the human condition. Like you have never heard of. Like this child, she turned 9 today. This child has no wisdom in her. She just turned 9 today, not gonna hold you.
They don't have so very long before their judgment day. So won't you make them
away from the dystopia of that which we are in? You ain't never heard nobody speak that way.
In the spirit of Sojourner Truth.
I put her on the payroll. And so Peso's like, but that's a child. I was like, you need that child.
I know we
when I'm sick, she can run it. And you gotta see how with a sultry, deep, like where she comes, she goes down on it. Like, now miss, now miss, now miss, now miss, now miss.
They
in
do
life,
it every
you know,
time.
They do a lot of shenanigans and things, yeah. But in life, we have to teach them to get
no
we have to give them chances. Yeah, and I have to stand up. I have to say, oh, yeah, for sure.
Let
yeah,
it be.
Yeah,
be
yeah.
Me.
And I have to listen to feel that.
World won't get
and
no
better.
We got to change it. Just
you
and
know what? Your friend SpongeBob over here. Oh, yes. And I'm very loud. Now, the whole neighborhood. They know we hear a lot. You see a star.
Can't do it alone.
There's nothing basic about
you,
yes,
too.
Oh, no. There's nothing at all. Oh, no, Mr. Muir. I got Mr. Muir here with me. He's Alana's biggest cheerleader, her biggest fan. You got to see when she speaks.
You see,
that's the child. But the child, it acts like it's a child. It's like third grade going on 30.
Like, that's why I just talked to them, like they're 38. And then she has such a capacity for love and empathy. Like, she cares for her brother. She does not yell. She keeps her face. She does not lose it. She doesn't go in the corner. She's stood, and then an advocate for the kids. Can we get a break? We haven't eaten in May. This ain't the math. They're in the math. They're in the minion math. Yes, we're in front of the right house, right? 1, 3, 2, 4, 5. Right, we're here, right? 1, 3, 2. Wait, are we in the right house?
1, 3, 2, 4, 5. This is it.
Yeah, 1, 3, 2, 4, 5, 220 Street. Yeah,
we're gonna call her and have her come out.
Okay, lovely. Okay, call her. Okay, bye. Bye. Oh, praise. She's going to call her. The kid, I know the kid hears me. She's probably like, that crazy lady following me up in here. Oh, yes. Oh, it's April's Day. It's Mother's Day weekend.
Yes,
no, where are you going? Where are you going? Did you cook up them lobster tails?
No, she's going to do that tomorrow.
I didn't know that you were allergic to fish. I don't know what these. I'm not good at this. I feel awful.
No, her and Peachy and
she and
Denise,
Peachy can't eat. They can't.
No, they do. They will.
Oh, they do.
Oh, yes.
So the ladies of the home.
Ladies,
that's most important.
It,
leading ladies.
The ladies
of the
it.
Legendary Muir home. Oh, yes. One of the kids afraid because she's like, and I always tell them, I'm like, now don't answer the door. A man might be there. Oh no, miss. I said, stay to your bedroom like Miss DeVito. Lock the door. Mm-hmm. When they have to go to the bathroom, Miss, maybe, I said, let it out. Of course, you may be excused. Then we had the conversation with Robert Shamik Jones. He's like, Miss, I have a shy thing. I was like, oh, you have a shy wee? Oh my God, raise your hand if you have a shy wee like Robert. Everybody put their hand up. Nobody likes to use them troughs. Them troughs that are like in the Yankee Stadium. I said, Robert, go in the store, lock the door. Lock the damn dead door. Nobody, you know, I don't like them, miss. What if somebody's looking, somebody taking a sneaky peek? I said, don't worry. You go in there, you lock the door with those men. Leave the men out there for the truck. Not gonna have none of that. Oh no, coming up. Like the slides that we make in Black Studies, they leave the lesson. I don't have to do nothing. Then in the chat, Miss Link, please, could you like, they don't want me to do like the good morning, the welcome. They don't even smile, they don't even laugh. The principal's like, your kids don't laugh. Do you know that? And I'm like, well, no, they're very serious. Yes, ma'am. She looked at me. They're in third grade. I was like, that is not steeped in fact. They look like they are in third grade, but you know, society have a lot of labels on us now. They have a lot of labels. And that does not mean just because that is say third grade, that their mind, they have the grit mindset. Grit mindset.
Right.
Yeah, birth of a 38-year-old, 40-year-old. That's why I can't. It's like you compare a man nowadays, any man, he black, white, purple, green, who knows? He don't compare. You know the man said to me, this is a different man now. You know what he said to me? Can you slow down? Yeah, Alana! Where are you? Wait, where's the kid? Where is it? I'm not, where's the head?
I think this door maybe.
Uh-oh, Alana! I hear Alana! Alana, wait, it's Alana, Alana, oh my God, the child! Oh my God! You came to see me, now I roll up on you! Are you real?
She don't get this other charter school.
This is my child. This is my Alana. This is my mother.
Dio is not doing this.
And I listen to God. When Alana speaks, sir, I feel like I'm going to church. I feel like I'm in the church. Oh my gosh. You came to see Miss DeVito. And Miss DeVito was driving. Oh my God. I'm going to eat your head. I told you I'm going to bite that head. I'm going to bite that head on your 9th birthday. I miss you so much. I love you. I have to come find you. Me and Mr. Me, you are the lucky friend, Mr. Me. We're the SpongeBob. Look,
hi, Lana. How are you?
I miss you.
Happy birthday.
I know. Happy birthday to you.
Cha cha cha.
Happy birthday to you. Cha cha cha. Happy birthday. You're the one and only.
I'm gonna
it could be.
Oh yeah.
So that's what he told me.